Namaste and hello everyone. I'm Sindhu Shivani Raviri and welcome to the first ever episode of Meet the Mahans, a bi-weekly series where we get to dive into the exciting, vast, colorful world of classical performing arts. Today, I'm bringing you my favorite artists in this whole world who also happen to be my own teachers, Raja, Radha, and Kaushalya Reddy. My guests are three of the people who are responsible for earning Kuchipudi global recognition. They were awarded the third and fourth highest civilian honors in India for their dancing. Through grit and hard work and dedication, they have taken Kuchipudi from a little village in India all the way to Delhi, to the Commonwealth Games, to Fidel Castro, to the UK, to Japan, Austria, France, the German Parliament. The list continues and continues. But most importantly, during today's constant media influx of dance that's touted as Kuchipudi but isn't truly reflective of Kuchipudi, like what we relentlessly see in films, my gurus have stuck to the traditions of the dance style while innovating it to adapt to today's stories. That's why they are known as the first family of Kuchipudi. That's why they matter. They are reviving and maintaining and refining and sustaining this dance form, which for South Indian American girls like me, means everything. In today's interview, we explore what even is Kuchipudi, and most importantly, what it means to overcome your own circumstances to become an artist. We get to even see a bit of my gurus performing live, so you have to stick around for that. I promise it's a joy to watch. My goal with this interview is to show you the contemporary power of Kuchipudi to break barriers and hopefully to open you up to a new dimension of self-expression that you may never have even heard of. I want to warn our viewers one last thing, that this is somewhat more of a biased and informal interview because in many ways I idolize my gurus. I was raised by them and I lived with them growing up. So my communication reflects that love, that affection, that familiarity. Please forgive me in advance for that. However, I promise you when I say they are legendary, they are legendary. Now, without any further ado, let's dive right in. In order to understand the weight and the depth of who my gurus are today, it is crucial to first understand where they came from, how they began. So let's start there. When my guruji, Dr. Raja Reddy, and his wife, Radha Aunty, or Radha Reddy, were barely teenagers, they eloped on a train from their hometown in Telangana, South India. They abandoned everything they knew, money, comfort, family, just so that they could pursue Kuchipudi freely.
Radha Aunty and Guruji, you ran away from your agricultural family with cotton mills and you, yes, you came all the way with 1 rupee. And then Guruji, you went to teachers and they said, no, you're a man, you're too dark skinned, we won't teach you. But then you still learn. Both of you still learn.
We were mad about the dance, Kuchipudi dance. It, because it is a Telugu land, Telugu language. We left everything. Though our parents wanted me to become doctor or police inspector, mm-hmm, something, I left everything. I was mad. So we came to Hyderabad and Radha's auntie came with me. And we learned dance. We went to village, Kuchipudi, mm-hmm, and Eluru learned. And we got scholarship from government of Andhra Pradesh. Came to Delhi to learn choreography. So after learning choreography, we knew how to present the dance items on the stage, like that. And when we danced this, here, the papers also carried our stories, Andhra dancers from Delhi audience.
It is like a time God chose
you.
So like God had chosen him to be a dancer.
If you look at the artistic landscape of the country, each region is colored with its own unique dance form. That dance form is born and bred within that state's distinct language, population, and traditions. For instance, in South India, there is Bharatanatyam from Tamil Nadu. In East India, there's Odissi from Odisha. In West India, there's the ever so notorious and famous Bollywood dancing from Maharashtra. And in North India, there is Kathak from Uttar Pradesh. And that's just four. There's many, many more that I'm not covering. So uprooting a dance form like Kuchipudi that is deeply entrenched in one part of the country and then embedding it into another part of the country is a rare and difficult feat. You're encountering new audiences, new dialect, new perspectives, new judgment. Yet my guru successfully pulled this task off. They are famous in Delhi. The Prime Minister herself, Indira Gandhi, gave them residency here after watching them perform. It's their home base to this day. And I needed to know how. To begin this chapter, we have to establish first, what even is Kuchipudi? What are its core principles, tenets, and terminology?
Kuchipudi dance is from our state of Andhra Pradesh in South India. It's a combination of temple dance and theater, Yakshaganam. And it is a combination of four abhinas, Angika, Vachika, Ahadya, Satvika. Okay? And Natyadharmi, Lokadharmi, and Tandavam, and Lasyam. All these combinations are there in this Kuchipudi dance. Kuchipudi dance is not a nritta. Nritta means pure dance. It's a nritya and natya. We convey the, tell the story, universal stories to the universe. That is the greatness about Kuchipudi dance.
Kuchipudi dance in general is a sampurna kala. Where you have the painting in it, because when you're dancing, you're creating a picture. And when you're dancing, there's a music to it, so you have the music representing. Then when you're dancing, there's a bhakti in it. You're becoming one with the Lord. And when you're dancing, it is like the whole art is a capsule that is the dance. The whole sampurna kala.
Kaushali Aunty, let me ask you this. So many Kuchipudi dancers exist, but why do you think Radha Aunty and Guruji, of all the Kuchipudi dancers out there, of all the duos that might be out there, what is so great about them?
The technique that they practice, which they learn from the Guru, Vedanta, Radha, the Sharma, from the Guru. And also, I think the best part is Guruji, Radha Reddy, he's also by Guru. I'm the first student of Natya Tarangini, by the way. So I have seen, like, when he dances, he really dances like a man. His movements are very majestic, very virile, and very strong, powerful on the stage. And she compliments him by being very graceful, lyrical in her movements. And this made them very popular all over the world because they represented the male-female aspect of life. And also, they have a beautiful chemistry amongst themselves. So when they're dancing, I remember, you know, someone said, Radhaji, can you also do one show with Kaushalyaji as your partner? And in that one show, one and the only one show that I did with him, I realized that I do not have the same chemistry that Akka has with Radha. So they, even if he goes wrong, she knows how to really understand that mistake and blend into it. And if she makes a mistake on the stage, he really knows that she made a mistake and how to blend into her. So they have a beautiful chemistry and understanding, which I don't have. And they are phenomenal on stage. They really are amazing on stage. I fell in love with Kuchipudi after watching them on stage.
Yeah.
I have not seen any other couple or a male dancer like it in the day. And also, I think the height difference, if you see, he's tall and she comes somewhere at his heart, So they're both, when they stand also, like if he's behind and she's in the front, so both are so beautifully visible, you know. They have an excellent, I think they're just beautiful as a couple in real life and couple on stage. On the stage, they get the jealous of each other, one gets the applause more. So on stage, they are true partners, you know, trying to compete with each other. They don't need a third party to compete. So they have competition at home.
Guruji, do you want to say, would you have been so successful without Radha auntie and Kaushalya auntie?
She changed my whole life, beta. Because of her, my life has become like this. Because of Radha auntie and Kaushalya auntie. We are here.
And they're beautiful.
To dance. Yes,
maybe
we are dedicated to dance.
The guru would have not accepted him because he was rejected earlier. So he owes his life and his dance to her.
First the guru rejected me. That's why I didn't want to go alone. I took Radha with me. And we did Namaskaram to Prahlad Charmagaru. He accepted and he was very happy. That, oh my God, both husband and wife wants to learn. The thing is, Sindhu, we learn from the Kuchipudi village and from Eluru. In Kuchipudi village, the dancer, that great knowledge created with Siddhendra Yogi, this dance, combination of theater and, you know, temple dance. But in the village, they were telling the stories of Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhagavatam, like that. But the perfection was not there. As per Natya Shastra, we have to do the perfection of Chaturasram and Chatur, you know, Chaukam, position, Sivangi position, and like the Pampadam, you know, foot positions, body positions, and Hastavina, Mokharna, everything should go according to the Natya Shastra. So when we came to Delhi after learning Kuchipudi, we learned choreography. So here in Delhi, when we started giving performances, we used to perfect the movement, body positions, expression, everything. That created a history here in Delhi when we gave first performance, the full-length performance Kuchipudi. Nobody has done full-length Kuchipudi dance performance. And everybody used to say that Kuchipudi is a gimmick and there is no perfection. Everybody used to think that. But when we practice for 8 hours a day and every day practice and made perfect and presented the items. After coming to Delhi, the founder of National Museum, he was a great scholar and he has written a book, Art of India, this big book. So he has great knowledge. After seeing our performance in Kamani Auditorium, he came on the stage and he said, I want to speak. And he said, Today, three times he repeated. Complete dance. Complete dance means I have seen Sandavam and Lasyam. I have seen Purusha and Prakruti. I have seen Shiva, Parvati, Rama, Sita, and Krishna, Radha. And Raja, Radha, he said. So from that time onwards, we started using this. Raja and Radha Riddhya, Sandava, Lasya, Shiva, Parvati, and like that. He said, complete dance means it should be the combination of this.
As we talk about how my gurus conquered Delhi audiences, I want to also share what I think is the secret weapon in their arsenal, Radha Aunty's expressions or Abhinaya. I don't think I've ever seen expressions like Radha Aunty's in my life. I don't think I ever will again. Her ability to just immerse into characters, to really emote them through herself, epitomizes the acting and the theater that makes Kuchipudi unique and singular as an art form.
Radha Aunty.
Yes.
Abhinaya expressions ante Guruji kanna mi abhinaya e chala bagutadi. Abhinaya expressions nenu eppudu chudaledu. So expressions vastadi. ఎక్కడి నుంచి వస్తుంది అది నా క్వశ్చన్. ఎలాగో వస్తుంది, ఎక్కడి నుంచి వస్తుంది అది నా క్వశ్చన్.
ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు బామకల్పన చేస్తావు కదా బేట, బామకల్పన చేసినప్పుడు ఆ క్యారెక్టర్ లో నువ్వు వెళ్ళిపోవాలి. ఆ క్యారెక్టర్ లో వెళ్ళిపోయి ఆ క్యారెక్టర్ ఏమో, ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు ఒక నెక్లెస్ చేస్తున్నావు, దాంతో అంత బాగలేదు, ఇంకొక నెక్లెస్ చేస్తున్నావు, ఇది బాగుందంటే నీవు ఇప్పుడు నీ ఫాదర్ 7 వారాల నగలు ఇస్తున్నాడు, 7 వారాలు డ్రెస్ సత్రాజిత్ని బిడ్డేవు కదా అది నేను అట్లా ఆలోచిస్తాను. ఇప్పుడు ఎవరనే కానీ ఊరిస్తూ దాని కృష్ణ శబ్దం చేసినాం, కృష్ణ శబ్దం ఎట్లా పిలుస్తావు? ఒకసారి మెల్లగా పిలుస్తావు, ఒకసారి ఏమో కొంచెం ఇంకా మెల్లగా పిలుస్తావు. పిలిస్తే కూడా పలకడివి, అయ్యో ఏమైపోయింది ఇలా పలుకుతలేడే టీచర్ అట్లా అంటావు. మన టీచర్ అంటే పోతాడేమో, ఇంకొకసారి ఇంకా లబ్బుతో పిలుస్తావు అట్లా. అది ఆ క్యారెక్టర్ వెళ్ళిపోవాలి మనం. అది అక్కడ కృష్ణ శబ్దం మనం కూర్చున్నాం అంటే నా ఇది అది నా పద్ధతి అది, నేను ఒకటే అక్కడ చేయండి రావు.
Like when we were going together, beta, Nemo, me and Radha, so I used to get nervous actually on the stage in the beginning. I used to get nervous and expression out and ledu mukham meeda, only one moment vasteva mukham meeda expression out and ledu. But she on the stage, when she goes on the stage, the flow of expression beautiful. అది అందరికి రాదు, కొందరికి ఉంటుంది అమ్మా, కొందరికి ఉంటుంది. అది సింధు రిహార్సల్ చూపించదు, ఓన్లీ ఆన్ స్టేజ్ పోయిన
తర్వాత. దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ అబౌట్ మీ, దిస్ ఇస్ యువర్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ.
ఐ నో, ఐ యామ్ టెల్లింగ్ బేటా, ఐ యామ్ టెల్లింగ్ దట్ ద ఫ్లో దట్ నాట్ ఎవ్రీ డాన్సర్ హస్ గాట్. సమ్ డాన్సర్స్ వెన్ దే గో ఆన్ ద స్టేజ్ దే బికమ్ డిఫరెంట్ character. That Radha auntie has got that thing. So beautiful expression she used to do. And one incident I will tell you, that Miss Indrani Rahman was Miss India. When we came to Delhi, she saw our performance and she invited us to her house and she said, please become our party, our, you know, presentation. Yeah, when we present a performer. So for 2 years we were dancing. She was a Miss India and she used to get class audience. Not only in Delhi, all over in America also, New York also we came. So but when we gave performance here in the Sapru house, so we did little bit of, you know, she did Kuchipudi also, I did Kuchipudi, and Radha auntie also, she just 7 minutes item she did, and we did half an hour and this, she did 1 hour like that. And the next day in the paper, in the statesman, the tiny dancer Radha Reddy stole the show with a beautiful presentation. So that was the last performance of Radha Reddy to party with Indrani Rahman. She said, for next performance, I'm not going to take her. Then I was dancing with her for some time. Then we decided that we should dance only me and Radha. We should not become part of other performers. So that's why we became performers and perfection, and we popularized all over the world.
To demonstrate in person a bit of the theater aspect Radha Aunty just described, my Guruji and I decided to perform a little just tidbit of the dialogue from Bama Kalapam for you all. I hope you enjoy.
One more special thing about Kuchipudi is Vachikam, Vachika Abhinayam. So how in Bhama Kalapam, the Sutradhara comes and asks Satya Bhama certain question. So she answers. He asked the name of her lord. So those days in India, the ladies were not taking the name of their husbands. Like that, suppose if somebody asked that, you know, Meena was not taking her husband's name. Sindhu's father, where are you? That people you are asking for you like that. But these days, time has changed now. Yes. This is Kali Yuga. Yeah, when your people come and this thing, and Meena says, Tulsi, get me 4 cups of tea, like that. So time has changed now. So how Satya Bhama, without taking her husband's name, giving identity, that you become Satya Bhama and I become Sutradhara, will show the Vachika Abhinayam Sindhu. Okay?
Thank you, Guruji. I'll try.
Satya Bhama. Oh, Satya Bhama. Ni Swami Varu నీ స్వామి వారు ఏ అందము వాడు ఏ చందము వాడు నఖశిఖ పర్యంతం శిఖనఖ పర్యంతం వర్ణించుకు రావే రావే ఓ సత్యభామా.
ఓయమ్మ మాధవి.
ఏమిటమ్మా?
నా స్వామి శంఖము ధరించినటువంటి వాడే ఓయమ్మ.
శంఖమును ధరించినటువంటి వాడా? శంఖమును ధరించినటువంటి వాడు, శంఖమును ధరించినటువంటి వాడు. జంగమ వారి ఇంటి కుర్రవాడు నీ భర్త కాడే కాడే ఓ సత్యభామ.
ఓయమ్మ మాధవి.
ఏమిటమ్మా?
నా స్వామి చక్రము ధరించినటువంటి వాడే.
చక్రమును ధరించినటువంటి వాడా? చక్రం ధరించినటువంటి వాడు, వాడు కుమ్మరి వారి ఇంటి కుర్రవాడు, కుండలు చేసే కుర్రవాడమ్మా నీ భర్త కాడు కాడే ఓ సత్యభామ.
అది కాదే ఓయమ్మ.
మరేమిటమ్మా?
నా స్వామి.
నీ స్వామి?
నా స్వామి శరమున నెమిలి పించమును ధరించినటువంటి వాడే ఓయమ్మ.
ఓ, నెమిలి పించము, శిరమున నెమిలి పించము ధరించినటువంటి వాడా? శిరమున నెమిలి పించము ధరించినటువంటి వాడు అడవిలో ద్రిమ్మదించు చెంచువాడమ్మా నీ భర్త ఎలాగవుతాడు, ఎలాగవుతాడు ఏవో సత్యభామ కాడు.
ఓయమ్మ మాధవి, నా స్వామి, నా స్వామి మకర కుండలములు ధరించినటువంటి వాడే.
మకర కుండలం అంటే ఏంటి? చూయించు.
మకర కుండలం.
మకర కుండలము ధరించినటువంటి వాడా? మకర కుండలములు ధరించినటువంటి వాడు, మకర కుండలములు ధరించినటువంటి వాడు. ఓం సహనాభవతు సహనం భునత్తు. వాడు బ్రాహ్మణ వారి ఇంటి కుర్రవాడు నీ భర్త ఎలాగవుతాడమ్మా కాడే ఓ సత్యభామ.
అమ్మ మాధవి.
ఏమిటమ్మా?
నా స్వామి బావ మరిది సందువాడే.
అంటే బావ మరిది సందువాడు అంటే నీ భర్త పేరు ఊరు అది ఏమి లేదుటే సత్యభామ. నీ స్వామివారి పేరేమిటో చెప్పగలవా?
పేరా?
అవునమ్మా.
ఇంతోటి ఆడవారిలో,
ఇంతోటి ఆడవారిలో,
ఇంతోటి మగవారిలో,
ఇంతోటి మగవారిలో ఏం జరిగిందమ్మా?
సత్యభామ.
సత్యభామ?
సత్యభామ నా మగని పేరు చెప్పిందంటే అబ్బా అబ్బా సిగ్గుగాదటే ఓయమ్మ.
పేరు దిస్ ఈజ్ వాచికం. ఇన్ అదర్ డాన్స్ స్టైల్స్, మెనీ డాన్స్ స్టైల్స్ దే డోంట్ హ్యావ్ దిస్ వాచిక అభినమ్, బట్ ఇన్ కూచిపూడి we have this vachikam and audience they enjoy. The conversation they enjoy. Satyabhama. తన మగని పేరు చెప్పిందంటే సిగ్గుగా అదటే ఓయమ్మా. నా మగని పేరు యూసెడ్ నా మగని పేరు.
In the 70s and 80s, Kuchipudi was looked down upon by many other classical disciplines in North India. My gurus overcame the burden of earning respect and recognition for their art form. They overcame being looked down upon to being the favorite of the prime minister. However, the subsequent process of earning global recognition, surpassing geographical boundaries, that presents a whole new level of challenging.
People used to feel Kuchipudi was not a very practical kind of an art. It was not a very serious one. Used to call it as a nakra dance, a filmy dance, used to call it. So it took us a while to establish that there's a lot of substance and a lot of weight to Kuchipudi.
And when we performed for this UNESCO conference in Stockholm, the Bengt Hager, the chairman of the UNESCO, he came on the stage. He said, Mr. Reddy, Mrs. Reddy, whatever we are doing in this country, whatever the other countries are also doing, it's a copy of Indian dance. India is known for dance. He said like that.
Wow.
Yes, the greatness of our dance, beta.
Yeah.
I should tell you that when it comes to the other styles of Kuchipudi, Kuchipudi always has an upper hand. And all these dancers like Yamini Krishnamurti, Biju Maharaj, Sindhiteet and Chavu, and Raja Radha Reddy would perform, people like Yakshapani. They should be the last one to be performing. That used to be the impact of Kuchipudi.
Yeah.
People used to be little insecure, like Kuchipudi would take it away. For Commonwealth, for instance, for the inaugural show when we did the opening ceremony, our composition, our Kuchipudi stood out. It's such a vivacious style. It just beats all the other styles.
Yeah, I agree.
Growing up in America, I was absolutely ashamed to be a classical Indian dancer. I always felt that audiences from other cultures, especially Americans, would just never find Kuchipudi thrilling or compelling the way they might find hip hop or jazz or ballet to be. So you can imagine my complete surprise when I found that my Kuchipudi gurus performed on the Mississippi River for President Gerald Ford, that they were the first ones who post-apartheid inaugurated the Playhouse Theater in South Africa when it was first opened to the public. That they were invited to teach at Juilliard, an offer that they rejected, by the way. I still get really mad at Guruji about that. I needed to know, for that child in me who was ashamed of Kuchipudi, how did my gurus make it so appealing to all these cultures around the world while I was in America hating it? What was going on? Why was I not able to see something in this art form? Was it because of my own internalized racism or hatred or shame of my own culture? Or was it something else? I now know, after speaking to them, that there are three core answers to my questions. Number one, there is a clear disconnect. The Kuchipudi you see in America, that I saw in America growing up, is so fundamentally different than what my gurus do. There are many contemporary dilutions of this dance form. We see misrepresentations often in film and popular culture, even by prolific actors and dancers that I love too. These dilutions have changed the very DNA of Kuchipudi to the point where today it is wrongly labeled as this unstructured, gimmicky, less respected variant of Bharatanatyam. That's the same type of dialogue my gurus encountered and fought so hard against in Delhi during the 70s and 80s when they first went there. To see a parallel of that same narrative in the States, it breaks my heart.
Experiment, but don't the river where it is run. That will be very likely to sit like there is a river that is flowing. The old water should flow out and new water should come, but your bank should be intact. The bank should be intact. And that is what you have to take care of, so that your Kuchipudi does not start looking like something else. Yeah, because so much at times you can't make out whether they're doing Bharatanatyam or whether Kuchipudi, whether they're doing Odissi. Like in the name of contemporary and fusion, they are actually confusing the whole world. That is not what the traditional gurus were teaching.
Kaushalya Aunty's answer brings me to the second reason why my teacher's brand of Kuchipudi in particular is able to transcend geographical limits. Their guru. Your guru is immeasurably important. In America, there are dozens, but very few actually carry the torch, the genuine upholstery of Kuchipudi. To every parent or student watching, I want to emphasize with every piece of my soul, please pick a good guru. That guru will define whether you carry on and inject true Kuchipudi into the next generation or just a false mimicry of it. That guru will form your basis and understanding of the entire dance. That guru will define your values. They'll define what you pour into the discipline: humility, creativity, innovation, courage. Just take a look.
You three are my Mahans, but who is Mahan to you?
Mahan to me is our guru, Vedantam Prahlad Sharma Garu. He was a great scholar and a perfection master. That perfection, Sindhu, I have not seen any other master, the perfection. Even the knowledge also. If you ask something about this, what is it? He will recite shloka immediately. Then we were invited to Avinod International Dance Festival. When my Guruji also came and he did Natuvangam, after seeing our presentation on the stage, he said, students only not learning with the Guru. Guru also learns from the students.
I remember.
Yes, yes. So he was that great Guru.
You told me also after you got Padma Bhushan, you did one mistake and he threw something at your feet.
Yes, Padma Sri. After getting Padma Sri, I was dancing for... ministry organized lecture demonstration performance. Then when I was dancing, I was so my Guruji used to go down, duck with the hands and body the ground and keep the chokam safe like that. Tajam tatu. So I was bit not doing the perfection. Then he threw his sala and I was insulted in front of all the teachers. I felt so insulted. This is not the way Guruji is. Then I realized that is the real bhakti. You got Padma Sri, you forgot perfection. That is the real bhakti of Guru.
Whether he's holding you, beating you, or loving you, that is like parents, you know. So you have to take it in your stride and you should appreciate it. And it was like a ocean. Every time you would come with something new. As a kid, as a teenager, I never understood. Now that I'm teaching and I'm into this profession, now I understand what a great man he was.
Yes.
He would sleep, and how he would sleep, he would speak it. Even in sleep, he would dance. So I was a child, I would say, there are no good he dances.
The third reason why my gurus were able to overcome the negative stereotyping of Kuchipudi and share it globally was because of language. As I grew up, I always thought that the classical Indian arts had to adhere to their roots. Therefore, Kuchipudi, being from Andhra Pradesh, would always be done in the Telugu language of South India. And this is what I had consistently seen in where I was from. The same stories, the same format, the same rote machinery and formula. That's boring to anyone, especially a bratty teenager like myself. But my gurus broke this tradition and used language as a key to unlocking the gateways to different countries and cultures. and to expanding the format of Kuchipudi.
You know, Natya Shastra is a great Shastra. One of the vritti says, if we are going to some other region from your region, you have to be clever enough to choose the language and music. But Kuchipudi, you should keep the grammar of Kuchipudi intact and use the language, that region's language, and you choreograph items. Your program will be appreciated and people will understand what exactly the theme is. From that time, we started choreographing items in Hindi and also in Urdu and also in English. And Hindi means Tulsi's Ramayanam, which is Tulsidas Ramayanam. You know Tulsidas, who is Tulsi?
My dad is Tulsi.
Tulsi is there at your home. He created Ramayana and we started choreographing items.
What really helped was when Guruji learned the choreography from the lady who learned choreography from Balshaw.
Yeah.
In 1966, we came together to learn choreography. That, you know, when you learn choreography and when you are interacting with the world, then you know how to present the art.
Right.
So you're not living in a small little pond.
Yeah.
So you are like exposed. Then you are like trying to, methodize and reach the audience who do not know the subject.
Yes, exactly.
Then the whole process, what happens is you're trying to make your dance so beautiful and perfect that people are able to enjoy. Yet, you're not compromising with what you have learned, your grammar. See, you do not forget the framework. You keep the frame as it is. You do not fiddle with it. Yet at the same time, you have to meet the demand of the coming times or the times that you're living in.
You all worked so hard to give it dignity, class. It became a worldwide art because of you. Do you think it will survive and get the same support? I mean, Fidel Castro used to watch you and Indira Gandhi. Do you think the same amount, like same power will be given to Kuchipudi by such people going forward?
These things definitely would happen depending on how great a performer you are. And the opportunities will definitely come in and knock your door.
106 countries.
Yeah, 105 countries we travel. I don't know how many times we went around the continent. I don't know. Yeah.
Our Bharat is great, beta.
Yeah.
Bharat is great for dances.
Yeah.
Because from all over the world, people used to come to learn the dance.
Guruji's discussion of using language to globalize Kuchipudi emphasizes the idea that you can actually bend the traditional storytelling of the art form. You can tell new, fresh, current stories, stories of feminism, of personal experiences, of your home. Nevertheless, historically and to this day, Kuchipudi predominantly tells the stories of gods like Shiva, Ganesha, or Venkateshwara. I wanted to therefore ask, do my gurus actually believe in the stories they tell in relation to God? Do they actually feel this so-called divinity upon performing? Do they think God is listening to them when they're dancing? Is that even possible? I was actually pretty shocked to hear what they had to say.
So can each of you tell me the first time you really saw God or lost yourself to Demudu in dance or something like that?
Actually, he has always lost himself to Demudu. He knows very well. He's always at the feet of the Lord. He's like always in this Kailash mountain at the feet of the Lord. Yes, yes.
We went to Guru Sabarampur district. Then I'm doing Krishna Shabdam. Then suddenly Krishna standing in front of me. Then I'm doing, I don't know. I'm still seeing only Krishna and dancing. Then Kaushalya singing the universal and is Akka, she said. Then Krishna went out and then I started something. Yeah. I kept
Even audience also felt that she has not now, she is, I think, same to Krishna. Krishna saying she's dancing. Audience also felt that.
That's never happened to me. May Krishna come for me also.
Krishna will come to you. You should, on the stage when you go, don't feel that you are Sindhu. You should feel that I am Radha, I am Gopi. Yeah. Then definitely Krishna will come. You should become the character. That is a, you know, special thing of a Kuchipudi dance.
The theater.
In other dancers, in Bharatanatyam and other dancers, they said, Krishna has done this, and Radha did this, and there was the fighting between them, like that they said. Mm-hmm. But here, when Kuchipudi, we come as a character.
Mm-hmm.
When I come as Krishna. Radha comes as Gopi or Radha, like that. Mm-hmm. And Shiva's story also, I come as Shiva. And she comes as Parvati.
In other styles in Bharatanatyam, we act as a third party. Whereas in Kuchipudi, we become the characters and we become part and parcel of the story.
So
are narrating it by becoming the character.
It is called beta Natva Mela and Natya Mela. Natva Mela is the one which was being danced by ladies in the temple in front of the god. And Natya Mela, the gentlemen, you know, the men used to perform female roles and male roles. They used to take and they perform the story like that. That is Natya Mela. So Siddhendra Yogi has combined this Natva Mela and Natya Mela and created this beautiful art. We are fortunate and you are also fortunate. You are born Telugu family.
No, I know. Being a Kuchipudi dancer makes me feel lucky to be a Telugu girl. All the Kuchipudi items, they talk about gods. You believe in all of those stories, actually?
Yes. I believe in God. I've seen personally when in Ayodhya, the temple, the mosque was, demolished. Then we were there. Previous day, we gave a performance on behalf of Uttar Pradesh government. So then we were saying there only the audience, like people like ocean from Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, from Karnataka, people came to see that. And all people were standing at this temple and mosque was there. So, and there was one rod on the mosque, iron rod. So nobody was daring to go and break that. They want to demolish the mosque because it's not part of temple. So people were waiting, and from the tree, the monkey jumped on that mosque, and the iron rod is like that. She hold this, the monkey. Yes. Then we have seen personal, and people started shouting, Bajranga Bali ki jay, jay Bajranga Bali. Then they started, describing the mosque like that.
God exists because you have to understand when Raja and Radha Reddy ran away from home, they did not have any godfather, they did not have any political backing, they did not have family support because coming from the landlord's family, which did not approve of the dancing, where the community is not into dancing. And there they came, it's because they put their whole art and their life at the feet of their facial form. And they just started practicing. If they have become so big, he never wanted to become a great dancer, he only wanted to dance. But look at God's grace. He's been so kind and graceful and so restful towards us. And I should tell you one more incident.
Yes.
This is quite large. We went to Tirupati. This was in 79, I think. And we were sitting at the feet of Lord Venkateshwara Swami, right at the threshold where they now they stop the bar. They have the bar where the pundits stand. But in 79, they had nothing of their sort. We were sitting at the threshold. And we were sitting there. And we were doing puja, and suddenly we see Venkateshwara Swami with his two wives. And there, that year, can you believe, we all three of us had the darshanam, and I got married to him that year.
Wow.
It's about faith.
Yes, yes.
If you have faith, then you can see it. If you don't have faith, if you don't believe in it, how can you even see it?
I'm going with it.
You only think of it as a miracle. Guruji doesn't remember this probably. We had gone to Banaras, Varanasi. And so they were having the stage on the river river Ganga, and they erected the beautiful stage for the first time. They had part of the festival, and all the audiences were sitting on the ghat on the steps of the bank of the
Ganga Mahotsav. It's called Ganga Mahotsav.
And it started raining. Then it was Gananathaya, I think we did. After Gananathaya started, Ganapati Vandana started pouring. And we were like, oh my God, we are not going to do the item anymore. So Guruji went to the mic and he said, Kashi Vishwanath, if I am truly your bhakta and truly I've been doing the seva and sadhana from my heart and soul with my body, and I request you to take the rain into your jada as you have taken the Ganges into your jada. Mm-hmm. I can't believe it stopped raining. It stopped raining. And at the end, after we have done the plate dance, it started just after the Teermanam of the last dinner, the last jetty we did, and it started raining.
Oh my God.
And all the national newspapers were carrying this. Like,
do you know they say only the best artists can make it rain? Only when God comes, it rains.
Yes,
you know
yes,
that?
Yes.
Only
yes.
God loved your dancing so much that they made it rain just for you. Do you know that?
Yes. Sindhu, that was a Ganga festival, and the stage was built in between the river.
Yeah. Wow.
The audience. So.
Teaching is such a huge part of the identity of the Reddys, so it's only fair we talk about it. Established in 1976, 45 years ago, my three gurus started Natya Tarangini, one of the premier dance institutions in India, built on land gifted by the Delhi government. I have seen them build this institution on their backs, brick by brick, to make it what it is today. If I may share more of my personal story, I periodically stayed with my gurus under their roof since the ripe age of 12 years old. 10 years later, they are still a colossal part of my life. That's actually me teaching my Guruji how an iPhone works, how far we've come. Anyways, I digress. The point is, like we discussed earlier, your guru defines you. They really carve out your identity as a dancer through brute force, through tough love, through soft love, through food. Now, we all know Guruji is a genius, and my absolute heart and soul, I deeply respect his choreographic innovation, his sincerity, his persistence. But I want to take a moment to talk about the two women that make Natya Tarangini what it is, how they have really crafted an incredible legacy. Let me start with Radha Aunty, the kind, maternal, elegant, warm Radha Aunty. She has wiped my tears. She has let me sneak into her bed during scary movies. She has seen me cry from exhaustion. She, despite years of training students over and over and over again, still comes into the dance room brimming with excitement, discipline, and a sharp eye. To me, learning from her helps me truly understand how to live, breathe, exist in dance. That assiduously working at Kuchipudi is the only way to conquer it.
Na Ranga Pravesha Maipaka Radha Aunty, I don't know if you remember, you hugged me. You hugged me so tight. And also, you told me when I was training Gurtundan, I started crying Ukkaroju, and you hugged me then also. Andar to, you're very, very maternal, Radha Aunty. Every student is a doctor. So, what's your favorite part of being a teacher at Natya Tarangini versus being a dancer? As a teacher, what's your favorite part?
Favorite part is nana. Our students when I pray to just some more, I chip in up for well, our grace could well send in a with Halish. A grace late by day, now Muru and the Razo name of TJ. In the case, a chase could dance of a meal of my polar. Guru injector, Guru of a correct to see, I'll correct a good taste for a follow up. You are under kind of favorite student on that.
I think it's a variety.
You choose a Yamil in this Atlantis
study.
If you were done for Atlantis, you say Yamil, dum dum.
Thank you. I have a question in the Radha Aunty. Radha Aunty.
Yes, sir. Yes.
నేను ఎప్పుడు చూస్తాను ఎన్ని సార్లు దశావతారం నేర్పిస్తావు మాట నేర్పిస్తావు ఆ సేమ్ ఫండమెంటల్స్ నేర్పిస్తావు రోజు నీరసం కాదా అంటే ఆర్ యూ రోజు ఎలాగ
మాకు ఇంకా ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఎక్కువైపోతుంది మాకు లోపల నుండి ఇంకా ఏమేమో
వచ్చేస్తాయి
అభినయ డిఫరెంట్ డిఫరెంట్స్ వస్తాయి అది ఒకసారి నేర్చుకున్నామంటే ఒకసారి అభినయ అసలు చెప్పేందంటే అది అంత పెద్ద ఆటిస్ట్ కాదు అదేమంటే ఒకటి లట్టు కొట్టి మనము ఇప్పుడు ఏబిసిడి నువ్వు రాసుకుని పోయి అక్కడ ఏబిసిడి మన గురువులు అంటే నువ్వు ఒక్క ఐటమ్లే తీసుకో అందులో వెరైటీ చూపిస్తారు అంటే నీలా ఆ కెపాసిటీ ఉందా అది దశావతారాలు అడుగున్న కృష్ణ చేద్దాం అంటూ నేను చేసింది చెయ్యను నాకు నాకు చేసింది చేస్తే కూడా బోర్ కొడుతుంది అది ఇప్పుడు టామ్ డిగ్రీ చెప్తాను చెప్పినప్పుడు నేనేం చేస్తాను కుంగండి గో డౌన్ అని చెప్తాను మీరు బోర్ అప్పుడు లేచి నేను చూపిస్తాను నేను చూపించిన నాకు ఎంత బాగా అనిపిస్తుంది నాకు చూపిస్తాను అలాగనే చెయ్యాలి
నౌ కౌశల్య ఆంటీ వేర్ డు ఐ ఈవెన్ స్టార్ట్ విత్ హర్ She is the force that keeps everything, literally everything, at Natya Tarangini running. She is an absolute perfectionist, but most importantly, she works relentlessly hard. I remember when she was sick, she would take me to her room and still teach me dance bit by bit from my expressions to every square inch of my posture. I can honestly say she is who knows my fundamental underpinnings as a dancer, my instinct as a dancer. She has this eye, almost like an X-ray, that immediately understands who you are as a performer. She is the one who will mold you and craft you into tip-top shape, no matter how much effort it takes, no matter how many late nights it takes. In the same breath, that she asks what kind of pizza and movie you want for tonight, she'll also humble you like crazy if you're getting even just a little bit high on yourself. She represents the perfect duality of tough and soft love.
I think I know too much now. Thank you. Whatever I know, I've given it to all the students. It's like I never held anything to myself.
Yes.
But yes, it's, in fact, whenever people take the name of Natya Tarangini, they're like, oh my God, I'm the first person.
Yeah.
We were three girls who started dance together. And I don't know, we just danced. And I've been dancing since I've been walked. I started at the age of five and a half. Then I've been dancing with I went to Mauritius. I've been traveling a lot with them. I've danced with them in so many important shows. So I feel privileged. And somehow, it is like I have tasted the nectar and I cannot stay with them. Mm-hmm. I don't think I can ever stay away from Kuchipudi and Natya Tarangini. Mm-hmm. So it is like, it has become my, what is it called, my soul, my everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have, only thing that I have done good is, I think I started Parampara TV.
One key role of Kaushalya Aunty for every single performance is that of the Natuvangam, which literally translates to the controlling center. Physically, it refers to the rhythmic cymbals instrument. I have never in my life heard anyone play the Natuvangam the way she does. She single-handedly, with her presence, orchestrates and conducts the feel, the soul of this whole show.
I asked Kaushalya Aunty, you do the Natuvangam, which many people don't know what Natuvangam is. Can you explain it? Can you explain why that it's kind of the base for the rhythm of Kuchipudi? It's so important and it can change the whole tone of the dance.
To be frank, by default, I have come into the Natuvangam mode. It so happened that when Guruji was traveling to Southeast Asia, his Natuvanath, the man who conducts the music, he backed out because somebody offered him more money. So this about, I think, a week before he backed out, then I was roped in to do the Natuvangam. I didn't know A, B, C, D of Natuvangam, can you believe it? Because I knew dance, they took me because the organizer said, your sister-in-law is a dancer, probably should not be a problem for her to sit down and do the Natuvangam, you know, conduct the show. I just went, but the speed that they used to do, it was a yama speed, can you believe it? And my tongue wouldn't twist. So half the time, the Mudangis, who always has a permanent Mudangis, he was helping me. So thereafter, I started getting the feel of it. I just started enjoying doing Natuvangam. But I also enjoy doing Natuvangam because Guruji doesn't listen to me otherwise. Stage is the only place he listens to me. That is the place I get to dominate him. I make him dance to my tune. So that is what I enjoy. So for him, I use the bass and the male tone that I need to use. I love modulating my voice. Somehow, I started enjoying Natuvangam. So what I was taught, I don't like doing the regular way that people do. I should enjoy modulating my voice. That's like my voice and bass. And I can, you know, changing my tone to female, soft, depending on the characters and all. So it was like, I enjoy doing it. That was my intention.
Natuvangam is not that easy, madam. Natuvangam is not that easy. Natuvangam is Sutradhara. He is the conductor of whole. He dance, even music, everything, the rhythm, everything. He is called Sutradhara. That is very important position in the dance.
To put a visual on this concept, let's see some of Kaushalya Aunty's talent in action.
Now imagine if Guruji is coming as a Yamaduta or
okay, so what can you take with you from all of this? How can you harness your inspiration into something more? If you want to reach the level of professional dancing or even just start Kuchipudi, what qualities do you need to successfully attain those heights?
No, sadhana means the practice, but devotion. Oh. Bhakti and sadhana. So if you don't have devotion and this thing, you do sadhana, your expression will not come that. We should completely merge into that. whatever the character you are doing, so whatever the steps you are doing, completely you are into that actually. Forget about yourself. That is very important. Devotion and sadhana for the dance. So with that only, on the stage, you will become a performer, good performer. The flow of expression, the flow of movement.
So you are on all the time. So like you are living, breathing, eating, sleeping, walking, only that. And that is what keeps you happy also. Like during the pandemic time, during the COVID time, just imagine people are going insane. They're going into anxiety problem, depression problem. But artists who are very passionate about the art and dance, you will see them happy in any situation. They'll make best out of that situation because they are practicing and loving what they're doing. And the best part about this profession is you're so passionate, you are so loving it, then you get to see the world without, realizing. And you are able to give anandam and happiness to the whole universe. Because you are enjoying what you're doing, you are loving what you're doing. Message to the world.
My message to the world is, Beta, that in olden days, in Vedas, they said, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The whole universe is one family. So you see now, Telugus were not at all there in America. Now Telugus, so many things are there in America now. So universe has become one family. And people used to come to learn this dance. Not only dance, this dharma from our Gurukulam. Guru used to, they have to learn how Guru stands, how Guru walks, how Guru talks, like that. His action. They learn like this. And if you learn personally with the Guru, you will learn perfectness of dance. That Bharat is known for dance and it will remain forever, this divine art. And the coming generation, Telugu people, wherever they are, they should know the value of our Bharat and they should practice and perform and teach this great art to the universe. That is my real advice.
We are proud to be Indian and this great art that we are spreading, and whoever is there, wherever you are, we should be proud that you are belonging to this nation which is having such rich heritage and culture. And you should spread it and you should preach to people the amazing culture of
us. Well, everyone, that concludes our first ever episode of Meet the Mahans. Thank you all for joining me. It has been an absolute honor and pleasure. And of course, on behalf of the entire India Parent Magazine team, thank you from the bottom of my heart to my wonderful gurus for taking time out of their lives and hectic schedules to talk to me. I am grateful every day for this art, for them, and now to get to share it with all of you. But I cannot let you all go without seeing the legends themselves do what they do best. So please enjoy this small taste of my gurus, Raja Nada Reddy, performing live. I'm so excited to share this with you. And remember, as you leave today, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Namaste, and bye everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.